On a daily basis, I receive a lot of feedback on my videos. A lot of feedback I consider, and then sometimes I create new videos based on that feedback. Now, a topic I actually get a lot of feedback on is fish food. While I've already created two videos on food, the main feedback I get is people want it to be customizable to their needs and their fish, regardless of the type and size, while keeping it easy to make and the ingredients basic. Well, I can help you with that. Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a fish food specific to your fish that will prove to be easy to make and hard for your fish to resist, all the while keeping it cost effective and keeping it simple. At one point or another, we all have fed our fish frozen food of some sort. If not, well, it's probably one of the hardest foods for your fish to resist, based on its freshness, texture, and the more natural nature to it. With that said, how can I possibly show everyone how to make a food when you don't all have the same fish? Now, I can show you what I feed my fish. It might not be the best for your fish. My intentions here are to show you how I do it, give you some advice and tips, and then let you figure out the rest for yourself. I also want to include the price and the pros and cons to feeding it. We'll start off with ingredients. No matter what type of fish you have, we all currently feed them something. That something is usually pellets or flakes. So grab your current favorite fish food and check out the ingredients list. This is where you'll get some ideas on what you should use. Now you'll see that there's probably a huge list of words you've never seen before, but that's just an analysis. Most of what you see is just what's already inside the main ingredients, which is typically the first five things you see. Usually something like fish, krill, shrimp, or some other sort of water-dwelling animal, and spirulina is popular on the list as well. What I do is pick out the top three ingredients and start with that, and then accommodate them to what's available for me, while avoiding the fillers on that list like starch and yeast. Now I typically will pick fish, shrimp, and scallop. We'll get to the other ingredients later. Not only is it generally pretty cheap, but I can also be environmentally conscious and pick aquacultured tilapia for the fish to use. The same goes for the shrimp and the scallops. When it comes to picking the type of fish, try to stick with white flesh fish or something that isn't too oily, or it's just going to lead to fouling your water more than it should. To prepare the food, we first want to consider the fish we're feeding it to in the first place. Now, the best rule of thumb is to simply chop the ingredients up to the size of their mouths. Too big, and they can't eat it. This way, it's specific to your fish's eating habits. Now, in this example, I use 4 pounds of tilapia, 4 pounds of shrimp, and 2 pounds of scallop, making sure none of it comes pre-cooked. These are the three ingredients I mainly use, and yours might be completely different. So I'm preparing about 10 pounds of food here, and that might seem like a lot of food, but the key here is to make as much as I can to keep the cost low. With that said, I also am always shopping for the ingredients. I never actually buy it all at the same time. I only buy it while it's on sale. So I will buy fish 1 week, and a few weeks later I'll get the shrimp, and then maybe the scallops are on sale the following week, and so on. I just freeze it until I have what I need. That way, I only pay about $7 to $8 per pound. However, as we move further into the ingredients, you'll see that this eventually costs around $9 a pound to make. But given my tactic of buying it all slow, you don't actually feel like you're spending that much. So far, everything is easy to find and can be purchased at your local grocery store. Now, this does seem like a lot of food, and it really is, but I feed around 4 pounds of this food to my fish every month. Of course, this much food would probably last most people a year or more, but I'm feeding big fish with it, and we'll talk about how long you can freeze it for later. Making the food takes at least an hour. Chopping up all that food takes longer than I would like, but I don't have to do it often. Now, because I'm making so much, I use a clean bucket to mix it all up in, making sure to thoroughly combine all of the ingredients. Now, at this point, we can add in anything else we want. For me, this food is almost complete for my fish. However, depending on your fish and what you typically feed, you might want to add in more ingredients, like, for example, some meaty items like other types of fish, clams, oysters, squid, krill, or even some earthworms chopped up, or smaller worms like live blackworms. Then possibly some veggies like seaweed, carrots, kale, spinach, microalgae, or a favorite of mine, spirulina. Now, the list is really endless. However, the ingredients are mainly found at your grocery store, or even a pet store, or countless places online. Do some searching. Do some research. Finally, you might want to add in some vitamins or other nutrients, most of which are totally covered in the main ingredients. However, you can buy and add in whatever you like. Even things like probiotics that are recently being added to fish foods in the form of lactobacilli, which are easy and cheap to find as something as common as a Walmart. However, some of you might want to keep it simple, so for you and even myself, we can just go with a liquid vitamin booster. Many companies make them for fresh and saltwater fish. For this example, I bought a bottle of Nourish by Seachem and tossed the whole bottle in. It ensures I cover all the bases I might have missed. You can use whatever brand you like, but this one was under $10. For a saltwater additive, there's a lot of companies that make food additives for saltwater fish as well. Now after mixing it, I let that mixture soak for about an hour. Packing is simple. I like to make sure that all my food bags contain the same amount, so I weigh it out. I simply scoop out what I need into a freezer bag and then smooth it out flat. And I make the thickness of that bag about a quarter inch thick, so I can easily snap off what I need when ready. Once done, I pop that in the freezer, and by the next day, it's ready to use. To feed it, there's two main ways, frozen and thawed. You might want to just snap off a piece and drop it in your tank, then let the fish pick at it. And I do that for smaller fish. However, I also prefer to thaw it out in a bit of tank water and just pour it all in at once. This will come down to the feeding habits of your fish though. Now let's move on to my thoughts about it. This 10 pounds of food cost me about $90 to make and will last me just under 3 months. In comparison, I spend around $100 a month when I buy my food. Obviously, most people will not use that much, and it will last you a lot longer than myself, so I'm a bad example. If there's no air in the bag when you freeze it, it will last in your freezer for a very long time. Now, I've fed frozen food that was over a year old, and there was no difference. Now, some of the pros to the food are this. It's fresh food, and you're not going to get that in a pellet or flake. It's cheaper than buying, you know exactly what you're feeding, and you're in total control of those ingredients. You can medicate the fish directly with its food instead of the whole tank. I've found that it's almost impossible to cloud your water with it or stain any of your equipment. So it's actually a cleaner food to feed. I notice a huge difference in my tank and filters between feeding frozen and pellets, for example. The cons are this. It's actually really time consuming to make. Like I said, it's going to take you at least an hour to prepare it, make it, and bag it. The second con is that feeding becomes a lot more work. Typically, you're just going to need to go to your freezer, snap off a piece, and drop it in. However, if you want it pre-thawed, you have to go through those steps as well. As opposed to feeding a pellet or a flake, which is probably sitting on top of your tank, you just drop that in. Overall, I wouldn't feed any type of food exclusively, and even this one. You want to keep your fish's diet varied and mix up what you're feeding from frozen to pellet or flake. Simply because one day you might run out of one food or the other, and when resorting to something else, your fish might not accept it because they're so used to a different type of food. So I feed a mix of this food, and every few days I give them pellets. At the end of the day, I just want my fish to eat whatever I offer them, and I want it to be good quality. Anyways guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video and possibly got some ideas from it. I also want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next week for a new project.